Off we go. It's 15:52, scheduled finish at 5 o'clock, so, you know, we're kind of doing all right. Last round is strictly music, but it's all kinds of music, which is kind of, it's everything from Duran Duran to the Spice Girls, so. Which song, the first half finale of the show Wicked, was used to wake up astronauts aboard Space Elliot?
Gravity.
Pardon?
Gravity.
Margaret.
Defying Gravity.
Defying Gravity is the one. Elliot, so unlucky. Born Elas Otha Bay. Sam. He's not the only one. So Matt Laycock had pressed, and he was a third and a second behind. Sam, that's a good answer. But it's all too late, isn't it? Gaz and Rob Coombs. My goodness, we're not dead.
Super Furry.
Tiebreak.
Super Furry what?
Tiebreak.
Supergrass.
Oh, we're all right anyway, because she lost it anyway.
Yeah, yeah.
So all right, yes, fine.
That worked out well. Thanks for spotting the tiebreak. So 2 points.
I think there was a double tiebreak, but didn't you?
Yeah, there was.
The next one was two tiebreaks.
2 points for Chris.
Five.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, Deb, but...
No, it's all right, I got the wrong super.
Yeah. Should I be finishing asking these questions for people who are watching? I can work it out, can't I? Which Oxford band? I Should Coco. All right. Next one. Who was the first Western pop star to play in Soviet Union? It's a tie. Could Steve Childs and Michael whisper to the person next to them what they want to say? Okay, we're going for Steve.
Elton John.
No!
Well, it's
absolutely not.
It's
one of those things. So
it's a tie game with Chris and Mark.
Right, Chris and Mark, could you whisper your answers, please?
Matt Laycock, right?
Matt,
yeah. Right, what the same?
Elvis?
No?
No, it's not Mark.
I was going to say Elton John. So.
Mark Preston?
George Michael?
No. Five?
One.
Des?
Sting?
Rhodes.
That's my one gone, so no.
Bren.
Cliff Richard.
Correct. It's basically one of those questions which has existed for years, which people have always got wrong.
Are you?
Eddie Kendricks and David Margaret.
Temptations.
It was the 1st of September. Oh, yes, it was. Right, here we've got next. Written by the late Bobby Womack, name the Rolling Stones' first UK number one, which begins with the lyrics, well, my big Sam.
All right, man.
Clive.
Last guy.
Margaret.
No, I was
going to
say last
one. -1, -1, -1. Minus one for Sam. Minus one for Sam, minus one for Clive, minus one for Margaret, Bren.
All over now.
That's what I was going to say.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's all over now. Okay, I can't be bothered going through the rest of it. And it's not as if you're going to get to 50 points. It's all over now. Meet Me Halfway and Boom Boom Pow were both Chris.
Black Eyed Peas.
It's correct. What a useful, useful 2 points. I nearly gave it to Clive. But just managed to stop myself in the nick of time.
My daughter will be proud.
Another number one question. Who's only number one in the UK was his 1968 hit, I Pretend? Sam. Oh, you're so got the...
Yeah.
Finger on the pulse of modern music. By what nickname was the jazz pianist and band leader Earl Hines known? Clive.
Like Fadder.
It was Fadder.
Yes.
Great answer, Clive. And that's not done your cards any harm with approximately, I don't know, 20 questions left. Born in 1946, Which New York female Billboard's top 50 albums were Horses, Easter, Debs,
Patti Smith?
He's correct, you know. In the lap. Well, with two other people pressing as well. I sometimes forget to mention that those people were there as well. They finish off with Because the Night. Do you want me to sing these titles or?
No.
Please. Okay. I could have danced all night. Debs.
My Fair Lady.
The Grudge match has taken a new look about it. 8, 9, 10. 10, 9, 8 in that order. Who reached number one in the UK on the 29th of June 1974 with She? Five.
That was the one.
Yeah. Which adult male singing voice splits tenor and bass? Michael by 300.
Baritone.
Baritone is correct, and then 2 points for you. Alan Smith, Nick Logan, Neil Smith, Danny Kelly, and Steve Sutherland have all been editors of which musical tabloid? Lake Up.
Enemy.
Enemy is correct. What a good 2 points. Oh!
I see the game.
As of 2015, who has scored 7 Disney/Pixar feature films, namely?
Craig Newman.
Films, namely A Bug's Life, Monsters Inc., Cars, Monster University, all 3 Toy Stories.
Oh, wow.
What was the name of Lulu's backing group on her first 5
others?
In which country were. It's not. Yeah. In which country were Alicia Markova, Omar Djalali, Lily, or whatever her name is. Matt Laycock?
Iran.
Nope.
I think it is Iranian.
Minus 1. 52. Matt Preston.
Iran.
Minus what, 1.
Again.
Sam.
UK.
UK is correct.
He was born in London.
He was born in Chelsea. Which Scottish group's first 3 singles were Chelsea Girl, Steve Rose?
Huh? Deacon Blue.
Not Deacon Blue. Mike Laycock. Triple Nines. Chelsea Girl, Life of the Day and The Changeling, and the UK number 1 with Belfast Child. Matt, you get 2 points, puts you on 54. Steve Rhodes, you lose a point, I'm afraid.
Yeah.
Okay, next one. Christmas Eve, Gary Coleman from TV's Different Strokes, Kate Monster and The Bad Idea. Sam.
Avenue Q.
Hey, it's Gary Coleman from TV Different Strokes. Yes, I am. Sam, a good 2 points for you.
The Bad Thor Monsters.
Such a good show. Have you seen Avenue Q yet? See you next time it comes to Leeds.
Good, a bit
crazy. Right, sorry. Who reached number one? Who reached number one in the UK on the 14th of October 2006 with America? Red.
Forgot it. Carry on.
Steve Rose.
Razorhead.
Yep. Born on the 27th of November 1942, in 1961, who joined the 101st Parachute Division? Chris.
Elvis Presley.
Minus one. Ooh. We'll put that on live. Clive?
Jimi Hendrix.
Jimi Hendrix is the correct answer. Sharing his surname with a European capital city, who wrote the songs Happy Matt Lincoln? Well, that's a useful one, isn't it? Happy Holiday, White Christmas, Easter Parade. 56 now. You're in that kind of 15-1 situation where do you even bother pressing now? What was the Spice Girls' first hit? There.
Wannabe.
Is correct. What is the 16th part of a musical whole note or a semibrieve? The 16th part of a semibrieve. Margaret.
Crotchet.
No. Man, Chris?
A semi-quaver.
It is a semi-quaver, which is going to be incredibly useful to you. It puts you on 52. Which British band released the album Exile on Cold Harbour Lane, which contains the song Woke Up This Morning, the opening theme used for all six seasons of The Sopranos? That's Preston. Oh, we finished the question, we got...
Yeah, I've got some review, but that's CSI.
That's CSI, yeah. Magnificent album, a terrific band with a wonderful programme. It's the Alabama 3.
Oh, God.
Yeah, have you heard of them, Stevie? Mendelssohn's Third Symphony, the play Macbeth, Mungo Park and Robert Louis Stevenson all share which...
Scottish.
Scottish, yeah. All share which demonym? Clive, you're making it too exciting altogether. It's 52 to you, 52 to Chris, 56 to Laycock. Under what name did Johann Holzell reach number one in the UK on the 10th of March 1986? Clive?
Falco.
Falco is the correct answer. 54.
So no idea how many questions are left?
There's one question left. Which 19th century composer wrote the music for the ballet Sylvia in... Chris?
Tchaikovsky.
No. Minus one. Clive?
Delibes.
Leo Delibes gives Clive 2 points. In third place, for definite, it's Chris. You let me down, boys. Let me down. I thought you were going to do it as well. We're going to have first to 11 between you two, because we shared the test with Mark, and it was very exciting last time.